Hey, John Sanmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question today about my billing rate. So whether it's real or not, and I found a few questions like this. I just want to say, you know, kind of upfront that when I say something or do something, like if I post on my blog post or if it's on my, like a marketing message or an email or something, it's generally true. Like I don't make stuff up for marketing purposes. I don't believe in that. And so, you know, just as a general caveat, like it's generally true, but I can understand why there's some doubts on some things. So Giovanni, I'm also pretty open with everything, right? So, you know, I'm going to be open here. So Giovanni emailed me and he said, hi, John, I just purchased your software developer marketing course with the email lesson discount. I think $199 is a good price for all this material. So by the way, if you're wondering what he's talking about, if you go to devcareerboost.com, he's talking about my How to Market Yourself as a Software Developer package that has you know, a bunch of lessons on how to build a brand and create a blog. And he signed up through my blogging course, which you can do at simpleprogrammer.com. And I'll also put a link in the description where you can go to the blogging course directly. And at the end of that, there's a lesson that gives you a discount on this course for going through the blogging course. Anyway, so Giovanni says, but are you serious about charging $300 an hour? Or is this marketing a marketing technique to attract more potential customers to buy your software developer marketing course? Smiley face. And for what technology do you apply this rate? For C++ development, I typically charge in the $100 to $110 an hour range. I think it's a good hourly rate. I would consider $300 an hour too much, and moreover, it's very likely that the clients would move away trying to find another contractor with a lower hourly rate, especially in this economic context. I think clients tend to be kind of cost sensitive. Anyway, looking forward to consume your marketing course material. Thanks, Giovanni. So I'm glad you asked. I mean, you know, obviously I encourage people to ask any question that they want, and I'm pretty open about this. And I was pretty open about, you know, in the marketing, I think for that package, I talked about how I had been charging $300 an hour. And so it's kind of understandable that someone who hasn't, like, you know, seen this and hasn't gone through this material and seen how you could do this would wonder. I mean, I often wondered, right, when I first started out, I think I was charging like $30 or $40 an hour. And to me, that was really, really good. Like, and then I had gotten this one contract where I was charging $100 an hour. And I said, wow, this is crazy. Like, how, I can't believe someone would pay me $100 an hour. And then I heard of people that were charging more than that, like $200 an hour. And you know, as I started marketing myself and building up a reputation in the industry, I started raising my rates and I got to the point of charging $300 an hour. And you know, the first time I threw that out to a client and they're like, they didn't even blink. They didn't try and negotiate me down. They just said that's, you know, they just signed the check. So it took some time to get to there, and I can understand the skepticism about it. But honestly, and I'll tell you this right now, this last couple of weeks was the first time I started turning down people at $300 an hour because it's not worth it. Now, really, the minimal that I'll do at an hourly consulting is at $500 an hour, and I don't even charge by the hour. I charge by the week, and I charge $25,000 a week if I do consulting, which I don't do much consulting. And there's a couple of things to think about here. One, I don't want to do consulting. I want to build a productized, you know, business. I want to sell books. I want to sell my course. I want to help people. Like I said, you know, I technically retired a while back, and now I'm just doing this because I want to do this, because I want to help people, because I enjoy doing this, and I want to build my business. And so consulting doesn't really have a big part in that. So I tend to turn down a lot of consulting. And then the second part of it is, obviously, you know, if you're going to charge something like $300 to $500 an hour, you're not going to be booking 40-hour weeks, right, with a single client. Like, you're not going to get a full-time position with a client. No one's going to hire you for 3 months at $300 an hour or $500 an hour. Or at least maybe someone would, but it's going to be very, very rare, right? You're probably going to have a handful of clients, probably like 10 or 20 clients. They're going to pay you for a couple of hours here or there. And probably what you're going to be doing, and what I do when I consult, is usually high-level strategic things. I'm usually talking to the executive team, and I'm helping helping them to help to make their developers more productive. So I'm looking at the value that I'm providing them. So, you know, they might be looking at this budget of spending $1 million on training or on this new initiative, and I'm going to save them several hundred thousand dollars by coming in and making their timeline shrink down. You know, their 2-year project, I'm gonna give them a jump start that's gonna save them 6 months. So if that's like a $10 million project, for them to come in and have me come in for a week and pay me $25,000 to do that, they're totally cool with that. That totally makes sense, and they're happy with that. So again, you know, I'm pretty open about the numbers and stuff, and like I said, I'm not looking to do much consulting work. If someone approaches me, I kind of got to this point where I said, hey, if I'm gonna do consulting work, I'm going to charge a high enough amount of money that it's gonna be worth interrupting my usual routine and the things that I wanna work on to work on someone else's stuff, right? Because I wanna work on my stuff. So I raised that rate and I kept raising that rate and I kept raising that rate. And part of that is because I've been able to build a reputation. And the things that I'm doing here, like, you gotta consider this as well, right? So right now I'm recording YouTube videos. Am I getting paid to do this? No. Right? These are all free YouTube videos, right? When I write blog posts, that's all free content. When I do my blog posts. So if you look at and say, you know, all the stuff that I do to build a reputation, to build a brand and an online presence, that stuff I don't get directly paid for. So if you took all those hours and then you looked at how much I might charge to consult, then you would see kind of the more realistic picture. Now, once you build a reputation and brand and things like that, then you can probably still continue to bill at an hourly rate, but there's a big investment, right? Someone can't just come out here and as a programmer say, oh, I'm gonna start billing $300 an hour. That's not even gonna, you can't even do $100 an hour, right? You have to have some kind of reputation or skills that are at least somewhat known in order to even do that. But there's clients out there, you know, and just to give you the, how far does this thing go, right? How much do people bill? There's certain marketing consultants out there that will come into businesses and they'll bill $1,000 or $2,000 an hour, or they'll bill, their weekly rate might be $50,000 a week. So, I mean, it can go as high. The key thing that happens at that level is it becomes, what value you're providing that's gonna save a company money or generate them extra business, and they're gonna pay you some percentage of that. So so that's where it starts to come, and I've talked about value-based pricing, and that's really where that comes out to. But so honestly, that's the truth. I pretty much, you know, say it as it is, and I'm pretty much honest and upfront about things like money and my bill rates and things like that. And like I said, I'm pretty much not taking any work at the $300 an hour rate at this point. Just it's not worth, you know, it's not worth the time for me, honestly. I'd rather be working on my stuff. From an economic perspective, maybe, you know, my stuff is not more profitable than a $300 an hour rate. I realize that, you know, but at the same time, I want to work on, in the long run, it will be, and I want to work on what I want to work on, you know, and so, you know, I don't, my price is higher. So, and, you know, as you go through your career, you'll find different points, and, you know, as you build up a brand, that's why I keep on telling software developers, that's why, you know, if you want to learn how to do something like this, buy my course on how to market yourself as a software developer. Yes, it's $300 if you buy it without the discount, or $200 with the discount, but that's cheap. if it teaches you how to get a bill rate of a couple $100 an hour, that's cheap, right? You know, you should, this is a no-brainer if you have those kind of aspirations of being able to do that, and anyone can do it. You just have to learn how to build it. It's not gonna happen. You're never ever gonna build those kind of rates without a reputation. You're gonna have to be a specialist, an expert in some area, have some kind of reputation and branding in order to do that. Anyway, good question. Thanks for asking this. Thanks for being bold enough to ask and question whether or not, you know, am I just making this stuff up? Because a lot of people might be thinking the same thing. So thanks again, Giovanni, and hopefully that answers your question. If you have a question for me, you can ask me anything. Email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, and if you like this video, subscribe to the channel.